Hey there, Carnage Cravers. Welcome back to Carnage Corner. I hope you're excited for Survivor Series, the first time ever, Raw versus SmackDown versus NXT. I'm looking forward to that tonight. I just got done watching NXT War Games. Had to watch it this morning because I worked last night, but that's neither here nor there. I know I'm a mess, but I wanted to get this out real quick. I wanted to talk about the War Games show because, damn. Normally, the NXT TakeOver shows dwarf the WWE pay-per-view just in the many times in the excitement, maybe not always in the storytelling, but many times in the excitement of the matchups and in the athleticism of the match. So depending on what you're looking for in a show, I know a lot of people usually prefer the TakeOver shows over the WWE pay-per-views. Can you even call it a pay-per-view anymore? Either way. Now, even though this is probably one of the best NXT shows I've watched, I'm still holding out hope the Survivor Series is going to top this just because of what we're looking at. But I want to talk about War Games real quick. So, if you can believe it or not, we only have 4 matches on this show, but god damn were they fantastic. So, the Women's War Games match, you had Team Baszler versus Team Ripley, and Baszler, as you can imagine, was the last one for her team. But the biggest surprise came with the Dakota Kai heel turn. She turned around, she comes out of the cage, she turns around and just fucking whoops the shit out of that Knox chick, fucks up her knee, and leaves Team Ripley in the ring with just Ripley and Candice LeRae take on all of Team Baszler. And Ripley is going to... She's the future of the NXT Women's Division. I can say that wholeheartedly. You know, if they do eventually... If there was ever a woman, I would say, hey, you know what? Shayna can drop the belt to her and I'll buy it. It's Ripley. She's fantastic. And she picked up the win. She picked up the win in this War Games match despite a 4-2 disadvantage. So I look very much forward to seeing Ripley and Shayna for the NXT Women's Championship after Survivor Series, of course, the next NXT show. So, then we went into a triple threat match. The winner of the triple threat match gets to face Adam Cole for the NXT Championship tonight on Survivor Series. And it was between Pete Dunne, Damian Priest, and Killian Dane. I like Damian Priest, like he's growing on me, but I've been a Pete Dunne fan and a Killian Dane fan for a long time now. And this match was great. You know, triple threat matches are car crashes a lot of times. You know, just when you think it's over, it's not. And, you know, somebody else comes in, and you know, it was a freaking car ride, so to speak. Dunne picking up the victory, you know, which is great. I hope that at Survivor Series tonight, Pete Dunne actually beats Adam Cole and becomes the NXT champion. I'd really like that. That's really cool. I'm a big fan of Pete Dunne, or as I've been known to call him from time to time, he is the tiny British Taz. He's fantastic. I love his work. I love that technical style, ring work and whatnot. You know, he's not... he can brawl, I'm not the biggest fan of the high flying stuff. I mean, it's got its place, and there are some guys who are very impressive and do it very, very well. And obviously I have no problem acknowledging the fact that they are great at what they do. It's just not necessarily my cup of tea. But here's hoping Dunne can pull it out against Cole tonight on Survivor Series. So then we went into Finn Balor versus Matt Riddle. And oh my god, I have never been pulling for Finn Balor more than I was in this match. I cannot stand Matt Riddle. Like, bro, put down the doobie, put on some shoes, and grow the fuck up, brother. Like, what the fuck is wrong with this guy? Like, I'm so glad that we watched Balor fucking take this guy apart. Balor won. I am so glad we watched Balor take this guy apart. Because I and here's the thing, I got news for you. Riddle, you know, he's talking about a match with Goldberg. I got news for you, man. If you ain't beating Balor, you ain't beating Bill. It's not happening, bro. Get the fuck out of here, stupid pothead. And then we have the men's War Games match. This was great. This men's War Games match has who is probably hands down my favorite character currently on any brand. Tommaso Ciampa. I was loving Ciampa's work. When he went heel, loved his work as NXT champion. Love his work as he's come back. Just this guy is fantastic. The way this guy works, the way this guy portrays his character. If this guy was, you know, 60 pounds heavier, I think Vince McMahon would be drooling over him. But in either case, Ciampa is fantastic. To be fair, everybody in this match is great. Everybody in this match is great. Every member of the Undisputed Era, no matter how much I don't like them, is so good at what they do. Okay? Keith Lee, I haven't seen a lot of him, but he's very impressive for a man of his size. Seems to be very agile for a 320-pound man. And he is, you know, he's a fucking tank. It's great. This Dijakovic fella. Again, I haven't seen much of him either, but what I see so far is very impressive. You know, he's almost got a little bit of that Ken Shamrock, Steve Blackman thing going on from back in the day. Like, you know, if you call this guy the world's most dangerous man, like, you could believe that shit. You know, so that being said. It was a mystery who was going to be the fourth member of Team Ciampa. And it turns out it was Kevin Owens, which everybody seemed to like. Except me, because I don't fucking like Kevin Owens. But, in either case, he came out, he took it to the Undisputed Era. I'm curious to see whether or not he will actually turn on Raw at Survivor Series, because, like, he went to NXT and, you know, was fighting, like, are we gonna see him turn on Monday Night Raw? He's on Raw, right? Sorry, everybody's been on every show recently, so I'm getting a little... Yeah, but... So I don't know, we'll see about that. But, so, closing in on the end of the match, and everybody's going through a table, you know? Keith Lee put Kyle O'Reilly, I think it was, through a table, and Bobby Fish got put through a table. Oh, wait, excuse me, Dijakovic put... Okay. Look, every member of Undisputed Era, aside from Adam Cole, have gone through a fucking table, okay? There's a lot going on. Don't at me. And then all of a sudden, here we have Ciampa and Cole on top of the fucking cage. Now, this ain't a cage match, so it's like, why the fuck did you two idiots go up there, huh? Like, what are you trying to do? Alright, so they're up there. Two tables set up underneath. You see where this is going. You know what time it is. So, fucking Ciampa gets Cole up in a fireman's carry type hold. She lowers him a little bit so he's across his shoulders. He hooks that head and he falls. What a bump. What a bump. Adam Cole, bravo. What a bump. And this guy's supposed to defend his title tonight on Survivor Series. You know, old schoolers might call that exposing the business. But then again, we did have Mick Foley walk back out to interrupt the Hell in a Cell match, to interrupt the first blood match between Steve Austin and Kane after dying. So, that being said, Ciampa got the 1-2-3 on Cole. Team Ciampa wins War Games. Everybody was fan-fucking-tastic. Like, this was so good. Like, it was all crisp. It was all tight. Probably because they were actually smacking the shit out of each other. It's usually when the best looking shit happens, you know, and just the way it is. So, that being said, I am even more psyched for Survivor Series after War Games, and hopefully you are too. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I am Ken Carnage, and until next time, remember, Carnage is right around the corner.